We are seriously concerned about growing human rights violations taking place in so-called Azad Kashmir and Gilgit Baltistan, whereby peaceful political activists and members of civil society have become targets of the state infrastructure with impunity. Terrorist network and infrastructure are very much intact in these areas. Leaders of the banned terrorist organization are roaming freely despite FATF recommendation. High-profile Pakistani Taliban leader Ehsanullah Ehsan, who act as the spokesperson of Tehrik-e-Taliban Pakistan, who was in the custody of Pakistani military, is managed to escape. Another designated as the terrorist as UN sanctions list of Jaish-e-Mohammed, Maulana Muhammad Azhar, who was in the custody of army, also escaped with his family. It shows that Islamabad still supports these groups, and she is not serious to take actions against extremists and terrorist organizations and groups. Honorable Chair, we urge upon HCR to ask Pakistan to take effective measures to control activities of those who promote extremism, violence, and intolerance in the region. HRC should ask Pakistan to stop witch hunt of Kashmiri nationalists and release our peaceful political prisoners, including Babajan, Iftikhar Hossain, and their colleagues who were tried under Anti-Terrorist Act and facing 40 to 80 years life imprisonment.
I urge Pakistani regime to respect freedom of speech and movement and refrain from declaring the people of Gilgit-Baltistan terrorists for demanding due share in China-Pakistan economic corridor. I urge Pakistan to release all political prisoners of Gilgit-Baltistan, including those serving life term. The locals claim representation in CPAC as third and equal partners, since both Pakistan and China lack a sovereignty over their land. Locals oppose unconstitutional land reforms and unconstitutional ordinance of 2020 imposed by Pakistan, as both rob locals of decision over land and cultural identity, while empowering Pakistani and Chinese citizens to abuse common property regime with impunity. Pakistan must not operate Gilgit-Baltistan like a prison for locals. It must open routes towards Ladakh and Afghanistan to let divided families reunite and enable Buddhists of Ladakh visit religious sites in Gilgit-Baltistan. Locals ask, if Indian Sikhs are welcome in Kirtarpur in Pakistan, then why are Ladakhi Buddhists deprived of similar religious rights? Why the double standards, Pakistan? Why? I remind Pakistan and China about their commitment to promote and protect human rights, including accountability for violations, and request both to cooperate fully with Council when dealing with disputed lands like Gilgit-Baltistan. This includes complete withdrawal from Gilgit to enable genuine stakeholders solve the chronic problem.